really rough week, right? Viruses, politicians, and elected officials behaving like idiots on all sides. I'm not gonna lie, nobody gets off the hook this week, I'm sorry. So we're gonna start there, right? Everything has been topsy-turvy. We've had 3 feet of snow in 48 hours, which I know for some of you is great. For those of us from South Carolina, this is a little painful. I'm getting used to the shovel. But, you see, everything's been off kilter. And it just reminds us that we need to be here even more. Listen to the readings today, and they are convicting and powerful and really terrifying if you have to preach this week after the week that our country has had, or 3 weeks that we've had. See, I spent a lot of time worrying about how do I approach this the right way. And talking to one of my friends and my colleague, he finally just said, Emily, Paul says it. We put everything in Christ. So here you go. Everything is going to fail us. Everything. Our government's going to fail us from time to time. Our institutions will fail us. Or have. Our families will fail us at some point. Our church fails us. Your priests are going to fail you, and the proofreaders of this bulletin did fail you this week. That's me. See, at some point things fall apart. But what doesn't fail us is where our salvation is founded. And that is there, in the cross, and in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Everything else is going to fall apart, and none of that matters. You see, everything is based on the fact that Christ gave up his life for us. On the cross, paid our debt for us, and then reminded us that he is God by overturning death on Sunday, on Easter morning. Done. Sermon over. Just kidding. Sorry. But really, if you all walk away with that main point, and if you're taking notes, that's the only thing you write down, that's what you need. The rest is what we do with it. The people of Israel are worried because they're fasting and they're checking off the boxes and doing all the things they're supposed to do. And they get no interaction from God. You have to keep in mind that they have been away in Babylon and they've returned, and so they're trying to recapture what it is to have a homeland and what it is to have God with them. And so as they are doing this, and they're fasting and they're doing everything they're supposed to do, and they are failing at it, because they know the letter of the law. And they have no idea why they're supposed to be doing it. They think they fast just so that they can appear better for God. Or they fast so that others will know how righteous they are. What they don't realize is that in fasting, you take that money you would have spent on food, and you share it with those who have no food. They've forgotten that they are part of the community and part of the family, that its primary goal is to love God and to show that love by taking care of one another. That is a very different place to be than to make sure that you're just following the law for the sake of the law. That's about your heart and not about your actions. Then you have Paul in Corinthians. The Corinthians are doing a great job of messing everything up. Right? What they're doing is they are fighting amongst each other and saying who's better and who is more saved than the other. Sound familiar to anyone? Based on who's the smartest. And I will tell you, if God's taking tallies on who's the smartest, I'm out of luck. See, they're putting all their faith in their wisdom and not recognizing how ridiculous they are. They have forgotten that it's not about who they proclaim to have brought them into the body of Christ, but they are part of the body of Christ, and none of the details matter after. Their salvation, just like our salvation, is in the cross and the resurrection of Christ. It doesn't matter who gets to sit at the front table or who's the smartest. It's about loving the God who has given up everything for us and showing that love to the rest of the world. I haven't talked to, because it works with my five-year-old, I speak to him a lot about, we love you, you belong here, you are part of our family, and this is how we behave. We love you, you belong here with us, and this is what Lukanichs do, or this is what Lukanichs do not do. It's the same thing I was telling the kids earlier. You are loved. You belong here. And to be part of a family called Christians means that we behave differently than the rest of the world. It means that we do not wear our piety on our sleeves. It means that we use our piety to take time to know who God is and what He calls us to do. It means that when we see someone in need, we address it. It means that when we see someone who is hungry, we feed them. When there is someone who needs a coat, we share ours with them. It means that we take time out of our day to hold hands with those who are broken and crying. And we do happy dances every time we have reason to rejoice. Even if it's not our reason. It means that we do not hold ourselves up as being better because of our actions, because of our behaviors, but we hold ourselves up because God shines through us if we allow it. And the trick is to stay out of the way while God is shining through us. It means that we are called to love with vile abandon. And that we don't check boxes, but we transform hearts. And we do all of that because our hearts have been transformed. Because we belong to the body of Christ, we're the family that follows Christ, which means that we need to act like Christ. So here's the trick. means that your leaders have to act like Christ. I promise I will not turn over tables today. But we are called to hold each other accountable to something bigger when we see injustice. It means that you all are the ministers of Christ. Therefore, when you see those things that I've spoken about, hunger, sadness, fear, that you are called to be God's hands in the world. And it means that you show the world that we are not what we have seen over the last few weeks. We do not place our salvation in the institutions of this world. We place it in the promise that is given to us in the crucifixion.